Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna. I'm joined again today by Dr. Venditti, our hospital system general director, giving you the update on COVID-19 from Albany Med. This morning, Albany County is reporting 146 confirmed cases of COVID-19. Here at the Medical Center, we'd like to talk about the results that we have gotten back. We have tested a lot of people over the last 2 weeks, and we have had 84 confirmed positive cases of COVID-19. I'd like to break those numbers down a little bit. We've had a total of 65 people that have tested positive either in the tent or in our emergency department who've not needed to come into the hospital. So that leaves 19 people who have needed to be admitted to the hospital. Of those 19, we've seen and discharged 7. That leaves 12 people currently here as inpatients at Albany Medical Center. The breakdown is we have 10 adults and we have 2 pediatrics. The 10 adults are broken down, 7 on the floor, 3 in our step-down ICU. But pediatrics, we have 2. Let's talk a little bit about that. We've not talked about children here before. These are our first cases with pediatrics. The literature does say that this virus is seen in both adults and children. The good news is one of those children is being discharged. Additionally, we know that we are a children's hospital. We have specialists, both nurses and doctors and ancillaries to care for them. In recognition of them today, we're wearing our children's hospital shirts.
Yes, we are.
And so we're very proud that we have the staff here to care for those children, and we'll continue to report on those as we go forward. We do have an adequate number of ventilators, ICU rooms, negative pressure rooms, and staff to care for all the patients in the hospital, COVID-19 or otherwise. And as always, Fred gives us an update on PPE.
So the PPE situation is the same as it's been for the last several days. We have adequate numbers of really everything, N95 masks, surgical masks, etc. I would like to say that it's really important, though, Dennis, that we carefully monitor the use of the N95 masks. They're meant for very specific circumstances, and using them outside those circumstances is not necessarily helpful for the patient or the physician or a provider, and uses a mask sort of needlessly.
We have to be good stewards of what we have.
Absolutely.
Okay, very good. We spoke about the employee health service hours expanding. We now mentioned that there's a presence on campus from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. I think we have some specifics on that.
Yes, we do. So it's going to be open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's going to be on M411, M as in Mike, 411. So 24 hours a day, we'll have the opportunity for our staff to go and be seen by employee health.
That's fantastic. Yes. So for symptomatic healthcare workers who might need testing, we can do that.
That's the place to go.
Wonderful. Any questions for me?
Yes, actually, Dennis. Talk to us more about the practice. We really always seem to focus more on the hospital, but the practice is important as well. What kinds of things are happening there?
So the practice has been very busy. Their leadership over there has been exceptional. We're moving cases to the opportunity to do from home, virtual visits, if you will. This week alone, there's over 1,000 visits that patients have been able to access our specialists from their home. And that number will certainly go up as the weeks go on. Pediatrics and psychiatry being the first places that rolled it out, but we're going to do more of that in the future. So virtual visits is something we're definitely working very hard on.
That's going to be great.
In addition to that, there's 8 different sites that we used to see people in. We're going to collapse them down because, quite frankly, this time those volumes are down, and we're going to redeploy those staff to various places within the hospital.
Great.
I'd like to also update us on our work from home initiative. As you heard me say in the beginning of the week, we're going to try very hard when we can to allow members of our workforce who are doing essential work but to do it from home. This number as of today, we're just close to eclipsing 500 members of our workforce who are now working from home doing that same work that they were doing here a couple weeks ago but doing it from home. And as I mentioned, that number will be going up, and by the end of the week we'll report it out again.
That's great, and I've already gotten a thank you from someone about that.
Wonderful.
Terrific.
Fred, let's talk a little bit about inpatient care, this population we're serving. We know some people come in and they're seen and they go home very quickly. There's another population and their length of stay may be longer. What are we doing to be prepared for that?
That's right, Dennis. So the patient who comes in is on a standard medicine floor with some respiratory symptoms. They're in the hospital for a couple days, generally get better and go home. The patients who wind up in our intensive care unit, particularly those that wind up on ventilators, the literature suggests that they're going to be in the hospital perhaps for weeks, as much as 15 or 20 days. on a ventilator before they get better. We are beginning to hear some of that locally in some of the other hospitals and our patient as well who's on a ventilator. So I think the expectation is that it's going to take a while for those really sick patients to improve.
But we're prepared to care for
absolutely
them as long
prepared
as it takes.
We've begun to track the amount of time patients, not only in our hospital, but the other hospitals that we're working with are on ventilators, so we have a sense of where this is going.
Wonderful. Another question for you today. I've had an opportunity to see you in Incident Command. I'll say it's been remarkable to see your leadership there. Things are coming in on a daily basis. We have to make changes. Can you talk about the pace of change and why we make changes when we do?
So things are moving very quickly, and as a matter of fact, as of today, I've decided to move my location in the hospital, if you will, up to Incident Command so I can be more readily available to the section chiefs. Sometimes we put out information, policies, guidelines that then it seems like we change a day or two later. And in point of fact, that's true. We are changing them. It's not capricious. It's not because we made a mistake the first time. It's because either the guidance from outside the organization or something else that affects those policies has changed, and we need to evolve. So you need to understand that. Our staff need to understand that. It's a rapidly moving circumstance, and we're trying to stay on top of it.
And when we do that because it's safe, because it's evidence-based,
yes,
and because it's a durable solution.
Absolutely. We're trying to do this based on science, the evidence, and the best expert opinion out there.
Great. Thank you.
Yes.
So again, today we honor our workforce from the Children's Hospital, but we thank everybody who's part of the Albany Medical Center family for the care they're providing for all the patients we take care of here, COVID-19 or otherwise. We ask you to take care of yourself, take care of each other. We'll see you tomorrow.